Trees, forests, and forestry are a part of who we are as Iowans. They're a part of our cultural heritage, they're a part of our current livelihood, and they'll play a critical role in our future. Iowa has nearly 3 million acres of forest, with associated industries supporting over 18,000 jobs and contributing $4.9 billion in annual economic output. This is in addition to the extensive ecosystem goods and services our forests provide, such as clean air, clean water, and critical wildlife habitat. On August 10th, 2020, our forest resource sustained a seemingly devastating blow, literally, from a derecho straight-line wind event. An estimated 1.75 million acres of Iowa forests, windbreaks, and urban tree canopies were impacted by winds far in excess of 100 miles per hour. The type, degree, and extent of damage varied dramatically across the state. Impacts ranged from spotty loss of a few limbs to complete canopy removal. So, what does this mean long-term for the ecosystem service, economic, and societal benefits that Iowa forests provide? Many folks are asking, where do we go from here? And can our forests recover at all?
When we first pulled up on Tama Street Drive here and saw the trailhead and the main access point, I was absolutely blown away just by how bad the damage and devastation was. I, in my mind, pictured much less. I thought maybe with some of the wooded area around here, there would be more protection and a lot less impact. But it's absolutely much worse than I ever expected to see.
Following events such as the 2020 derecho, we need to remember that forests are inherently resilient. They're never truly lost or destroyed unless they're converted to parking lots, housing developments, or row crop fields. Forests are not static. They change through time and actually rely on disturbance to maintain specific structure and function and regenerate certain species. As foresters, our management practices often mimic natural disturbances such as fire, ice, flooding, and of course, wind. Because of this, it is critical that we view this as a forest management opportunity and not an insurmountable setback. This is the beginning, not the end.